Good morning. A very warm welcome to all who have gathered here in St. Patrick's Cathedral on this third Sunday of Easter. Today we are reminded that Jesus' death on the cross was not just a coincidence, but an integral part of God's master plan to save his people. We should take a moment to be forever thankful for this expression of self-giving love. We acknowledge the First Nations peoples of the area, and we commit to working and walking together to build a better future for all. Please stand and join in our entrance hymn.
So we gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. And as we gather this day on our journey, both here and live stream, wherever you're watching from, let us turn to those around us and say a word of welcome. Welcome, Carla. Richard. Welcome everyone at home, wherever you are. As we gather today, we're mindful of the joy that remains in our hearts as we celebrate the third Sunday, 2 weeks after the celebration of Easter, the celebration of the resurrection of Christ. Mindful of the prayers that we bring, and there's some particular prayers, of course, if you've caught up on the news, and that is the tragedy at Bondi with 6 deaths. So we keep their families in our prayers and the effect that has on a community. We pray for the cease of such violence. Also aware that Iran is currently, I believe, invading Israel, combating Israel. So we keep particularly that zone in our prayers and pray for peace as always. Let us take a moment just to call to mind the many prayers that we bring that we place in the quiet of our hearts before our God. For ourselves too we pray, Lord have mercy. Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
For the resurrection of the Christ is the promise of new life which we seek each day. So let us praise our God.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
May your people exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our redemption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. At the temple gate, Peter addressed the people. The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our ancestors, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate, though he had decided to release him. But you rejected the Holy and Righteous One and asked to have a murderer given to you. And you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witnesses. And now, friends, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did also your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Messiah would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God, so that your sins may be wiped out. The word of the Lord.
Lord,
From anguish you released me. Have mercy and hear me.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
It is the Lord who grants favors to those he loves. The Lord hears me whenever I call him.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Many say, what can bring us happiness? Lift up the light of your face on us, Lord.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
I will lie down in peace, and sleep comes at once. For you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
A reading from the first letter of John. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins, not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. Now by this we may be sure that we know him, if we obey his commandments. Whoever says, I have come to know him, but does not obey his commandments, is a liar. And in such a person, the truth does not exist. But whoever obeys his word, truly, in this person, the love of God has reached perfection. By this, we may be sure that we are in him. The word of the Lord.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way, and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, Jesus stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you can see I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
There's one story that I always remember at Easter time, and that's the story of the man who goes down to the river to fish. And as he's fishing away, he's filling up his bucket of fish, and as he's standing there, another guy comes and stands beside him and says, "Sorry to say, but I'm a fishery inspector, and you're fishing out of season, and these fish look a bit small to me." And he said, "I'm going to have to charge you." And the guy said, "Oh, you don't understand. These are my pet fish. Every Sunday I get them out of the pond at home and I bring them down to the river and let them go for a swim. Then I whistle and they come back and I put them back in the bucket and take them back to the pond." And the fishery inspector said, "That's amazing. I'd love to see that." And he said, "Oh, yeah, no worries." So he puts the fish in the water, stands there for a while. And the fishery inspector said, "Well, are you going to whistle those fish back?" And he says, "What fish?" No evidence, no crime, you see. And so the question always is, where's the evidence of the resurrection? An empty tomb. Where's the evidence of the resurrection? And so we hear these stories of the appearances of Christ to the disciples. And we may think that this is the first telling of this story in the Gospels. But there are actually three tellings. The one we hear before is the road to Emmaus, the story we know, where Jesus appeared beside them, walked with them, spoke of the scriptures, opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and then broke bread with them. And then they suddenly realized their mission and God's plan for them. Today's gospel, the same. Jesus appears amongst them. He talks about the scriptures. He opens their minds to understand their mission and plan that God has for them. The third telling is our lives. The third telling is the here and now version of that. So the invitation is to recognize the Christ that is amongst us, that is inviting us to reflect on the scriptures, to allow God to open our hearts and our minds to understand what it means to be a follower of Christ. And within all of that is to discover our mission and our plan that God has for us. The meal part is the image, if you like, of each one of us that meets the risen Christ in each one of us. So every opportunity that we come together for a meal or otherwise, it's recognizing that the risen Christ exists within us. So the evidence, if you like, of the risen Christ is you and me. The proof of the resurrection is you and me. We're not witnesses. We didn't see a thing, as most criminals say. We didn't see a thing. We weren't there. You have to be there to be a witness. But we can be the evidence. We indeed can be the proof. Because every time that we give someone a second chance, every time we forgive, Every time we say words of encouragement over anger, every time we show compassion, prayerfulness, thoughtfulness, and love, we prove the risen Christ exists. Because the only, as Bishop Morris used to say, the closest you'll get to the risen Christ is the person you are sitting beside. So let us remind ourselves as we journey this week that we are the evidence of the resurrection. We are the evidence of the risen Christ within us, the way that we walk gently with one another. So as people of faith, let us indeed profess what we believe. We believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And from our hearts we bring the prayers we place before God.
For the Church throughout the world and all who lead, that by lives of love they will bear joyful witness to Christ's victory over sin and death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For repentance for our failure to care for creation, that with our sin forgiven, we will renew our pledge to hear the cry of the earth and the cry of the poor. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to words and actions that belittle and dehumanize others, that every human being will receive the respect that is their right as a child of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our local mayor and councillors, that they will serve their community with dedication, integrity, and care for the common good. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For young people in our Toowoomba area, struggling to cope with various aspects of life, that they will be blessed with the support of family, friends, and professional services. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the recently deceased and those whose anniversary of death occurs around this time, especially Shirley Palmer, Janice Gray, Maurice Musa, Father Marty Larson, and Brian Carter, that they will be led by their good shepherd to the banquet of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for those affected by the tragedy in Australia and the tragedy of war throughout the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, we gather these prayers and those in the quiet of our hearts. We ask them all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
To see God.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread and wine to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. May they become for us our spiritual food and drink. Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant Church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to lord you more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we acclaim. Holy and to be glorified, O God, who loved the human race and who always walks with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice filled with wine. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the chalice to his disciples. He said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We proclaim the mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, Holy Fathers, we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Saviour, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand. We proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favour on the offerings of your people, in which we show forth the sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and Ken, our Bishop, your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, that we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known, especially those for whom we now pray. Welcome them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our worthy pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the apostles and martyrs, Saint Patrick, and all your saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. So with the joy of Easter in our hearts, we pray as united in faith. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace, peace, Carl. Peace, peace. Peace, everyone at home. Peace over there.
Of the world, have mercy on us.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My mighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go now to be evidence of the resurrection of Christ.
Thanks be to God.